How's it going, guys? I'm Theo Joe. Now, you may remember way back in March of this year, I made a video called Is Your CPU Spying on You? It might sound a little bit sensationalist, and it had to do with two different types of technologies. First is the Intel Management Engine, and also AMD's Platform Security Processor. And these are basically two chips that are on virtually every motherboard, along with Intel and AMD chipsets that you cannot remove, but have very low level access to your operating system that you cannot disable, and basically has complete control over your computer. And I was talking about the dangers of this, especially if it were to get exploited by either a government or hackers. And a lot of people said, oh, that's just fear-mongering, you're paranoid, you're an idiot, it's not true. And well, we recently found out I was right. You see, Intel recently announced that there was a critical, major vulnerability discovered in the Intel Management Engine, which you almost certainly have in your computer. And it allows the execution of, quote, arbitrary code, which basically means that if a hacker were to do this and use this exploit, they could literally execute whatever code they want on your computer. And by the way, like I said before, this type of chip cannot be disabled, and it has low-level direct access to your RAM, your peripherals, all your hardware, your Ethernet port, and it can even be enabled when your computer is off. And not only that, but it bypasses the operating system, which means that no matter what kind of antivirus or security software you have running on your computer, whether it's Windows or Linux or whatever operating system, you could still be vulnerable to this vulnerability. So, before we go any further, I am letting you know you can patch this. You need to patch this. Intel did release a tool. It's called the Intel-SA-0086 Detection Tool. That's the code for the name of this exploit. And I'll put a link to where you can get this, and I'll put the link in the description as well. So I highly recommend you download that tool off of Intel's website, run it on your computer, and make sure that either if your computer is not vulnerable, actually my computer is a fifth generation Intel CPU, the 5960X, so actually not upgrading up my computer helped out, but if you have a sixth, seventh, or eighth or later generation processor, then you probably do have this exploit on your computer and you need to download the patch to fix it. So in addition to the CPUs I just mentioned, I'll just put a list of all the different ones that are vulnerable. And as you can see, it's pretty much all of them. The Intel Management Engine is put into pretty much every single Intel chip. And if you're wondering, well, what is the point of this? If you didn't see my previous video, why would they do such a thing? It's basically to allow system administrators for big companies to be able to manage lots and lots of computers without requiring employees to update all their software themselves. It basically allows a company to manage all their computers from one place, which is a legitimate use, but the issue is that it's such a closed source black box chip that nobody knows anything about it because Intel keeps it a secret. So that means that really no one can audit the code. And Intel did actually audit the code themselves because so many people were worried about it. And turns out the worries were founded because they did find this huge vulnerability. And the thing is, we don't even know if this security flaw was discovered by anyone else beforehand. If I had to guess, it definitely was, especially by, if anyone, it was the NSA or the government, probably had their eye on this software for a long time, and I would not be surprised if they knew about this for a long time. The analogy I made in a previous video was, imagine everyone had the same exact safe in the whole world, and everyone had them on their doorstep. How long do you think it would take before the government tried to figure out how to open that same exact safe? So really, that was the same analogy here. Pretty much all Intel computers have this vulnerability now, and if it was discovered, they were just shooting a fish in a barrel. And maybe the scariest thing is that because the way the Intel Management Engine works, and it has direct access to the CPU and all the hardware, it doesn't have to interact with the operating system at all, which means that if someone was messing around with your computer, you would have no idea. Because the Windows would not be able to see this going on at all. Linux would not be able to see it going on at all because the management engine chip, which is basically like a mini computer on your computer, would be able to possibly read directly off your hard drive or out of your RAM without having to go through Windows, which potentially would have something with security to block it. It wouldn't have to worry about that at all. Plus, when it comes to AMD, you might have heard me mention before, AMD has pretty much the same thing called the platform security processor. It's the same idea. It's a black box chip. You can't disable it. If you take it off, the computer won't boot, all that sort of stuff. And AMD has said they have no plans at this time to open source it. Now, there have been things I've seen mentioned called LibreBoot, which apparently is a project by people like hackers, good hackers in this case, who are trying to figure out ways to be able to boot your computer without this type of backdoor processor going on, but I don't know much about it, to be honest. So in the meantime, the only thing you can do is patch that flaw. You probably do have it if your computer was built in the past 3 or 4 years. So run that tool, it'll tell you, as I said before, luckily my computer did not have this flaw. Thankfully, I for some reason did not upgrade my computer in a while. It's one benefit, but it will tell you, and then you can download the patch yourself and fix it. So I guess that's pretty much all there is to say about it. If you guys want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here you can click on. And if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And also be sure to enable notifications by clicking the bell, or else YouTube probably won't even show you new videos even if you do subscribe because of that algorithm. Anyway, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.